dropping water on your fat cunt fatty? Are you retaining water? Is the scale stuck? And you're too much of an idiot to figure out why. Okay, is the scale stuck? Well, I'm here today to solve all your fucking problems, fatty. Behold, dry salt loading. Dry salt loading. Now, before I can get into dry salt loading, if you're too big of a fucking idiot to understand what I'm going to say today, okay, you can't follow fucking directions, mix all your salt and water. Mix snake juice and water always, always, never fucking dry salt load potassium. Okay, as far as the sodium goes, if you're too fucking stupid to fucking do this, fucking mix all your fucking salt and water. Okay, this could fucking kill you. Okay? I know we need to get rid of some fucking idiots on this planet, okay? But this could fucking kill you, idiot. So if you don't know what you're doing and can't follow instructions, don't dry salt load. Let's begin. Number one, before I even get into the dry salt loading fucking process, more fucking sodium, dummies. More sodium when you fast or you're on a fucking low-carb keto routine. 99% of you motherfuckers are chronically low on fucking sodium. All the salts, especially the fucking sodium, okay? Because as soon as you lose all your sodium, you lose all your fucking potassium, okay? As soon as you fucking lose your sodium, you lose all your fucking potassium. So as long as your sodium's through the fucking roof at all times, you won't dump potassium. Okay, people gotta get that through their head. Sodium doesn't fucking bloat you up. What bloats you up is being low on sodium, and then you're just guzzling water to try to get into sodium, but there is none, and your body's like, fuck you, and holds on to all that water because your body's in water storing mode, and you're not gonna let go of the fucking water until your sodium levels reach a fucking threshold. Okay? Water dumping in water storing mode. You're either in water dumping mode or in water storing mode. To be in water dumping mode so your fat cunt isn't retaining all that water, your sodium levels have to be high enough that your body is like, okay, we got enough fucking sodium, we can dump this fucking water, okay? Now, if you're loading up on salt, sodium, and you're doing it with water, water always follows sodium, all right? You could temporarily fucking blow up if you fucking load up on sodium with lots of water, okay? Because fucking water follows sodium, okay? But it's only fucking temporary. And then you'll dump all the fucking water because your sodium levels will get where they need to be and you'll fucking start dumping the fucking water, okay? But if you don't want to fucking get bloated up at that point temporarily trying to get your sodium in because you're fucking an idiot, you're low, that's when you can dry salt load. So it's simple. All it is you fucking just take sodium fucking salt and don't drink water with it. Or sip a drink of water down at the same time. Okay? This is how I get in fucking salt all the time. I just take a fucking full fucking teaspoon. I wouldn't recommend that to start experiment. But I'll take a full fucking teaspoon, 2,000 milligrams of sodium. I'll throw it in my mouth and just take one gulp of water to wash it down. Okay? One gulp. Okay? And then I won't drink a bunch of water. I'll just fucking go fucking ride my bike. And I'll fucking have energy of the axe. Because my sodium levels are where they should be. Alright, so basically, water dumping, water storing fucking mode, if you want to be in water dumping mode, you gotta have your sodium way up there. Okay, now as far as the snake juice goes, the packets have 1300 milligrams of potassium, 1000 milligrams of sodium. It's mainly a potassium dominant fucking supplement, okay? Because sodium's fucking free, you can get fucking salt for nothing. Okay, so this stuff, if you're a sedentary fat pig, three of these a day is going to be enough sodium probably. But how do you know if you got enough sodium? How do you know? You fucking, if you have enough sodium in your system, you're going to be pissing at a fucking regular clip. You're not going to be having days and days where you don't piss because you're going to be letting go of water because you're in water dumping mode because your sodium's high enough. And you're going to feel way better, okay? And you're gonna have fucking energy, and your piss will taste somewhat salty. At least my goal is once a day, this would be a good rule of thumb, once a day make sure your piss is fucking salty as fuck. Then you know you're floating right on that line. Okay, it doesn't have to be salty as fuck all day, but at least once a day. Okay, at least once a day. And that's for all dry salt load, because I'm not just guzzling water, because if you guzzle water and fucking a ton of salt, save your way down. Way down. Some of you fat motherfuckers are gonna have to fucking load a ton. Now be smart about it. Okay, but some of you fuckers, like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. Yesterday, I fucking did an experiment with fucking dry salt loading, and I took in 20,000 fucking milligrams of fucking salt yesterday. Do I look fucking bloated up? Do I look fucking bloated the fuck up? Fucking shredded right now. 20,000 fucking milligrams. Why? Because the salt I took in, I just pissed out the excess. I didn't hold any fucking water because I wasn't taking it with a bunch of water. But the snake pass you have to fucking take with water. Why? Because there's fucking potassium chloride powder in it. You can't take potassium chloride powder without fucking mixing it in water. It'll fuck up your fucking gut. It'll fucking burn you. Okay? You can only fucking even dare try this with fucking sodium fucking chloride. Okay? Or baking soda. Okay? Not the potassium, motherfucker. Listen. That could fuck you up, okay? And when people are always worried about blood pressure, same thing. The blood pressure would temporarily get elevated when you pound a fucking ton of sodium to try to get your sodium levels up so you're not in water storing mode because you're taking it with so much water. Okay, but what actually happens when you do it dry, where do you think the water's gonna come from? You're not drinking any, motherfucker. Your fucking body's holding 100 pounds of water. Okay, the water's coming from your body. You'll actually have a drop in fucking blood pressure because you'll drop water weight so fast. Some of you fuckers can drop 10 pounds of water weight in a day. Okay, and next question that'll come up. Well, when do I stop? How do I know I'm good on salt? Well, you know, like I said, you taste your fucking piss, dummy. If it tastes salty, real salty, you're good. Okay, but then you go back into a normal routine, getting in about 2,000 milligrams per every liter of water you drink. Okay, and then you obviously need the potassium. So if you're drinking snake juice packs, two or three a day, if you're not, and you're just using potassium chloride powder, 2,500 milligrams of potassium, maybe up to about 5,000. The recommended RDA is 4,700. See, with the potassium, it'll stay fairly fixed. As long as the sodium's through the fucking roof, you're not gonna dump the potassium. It'll spare the other fucking electrolytes and you keep your sodium way up. People are so fucking brainwashed on sodium. Crank it the fuck up. Don't be scared. But understand, if you crank it up and drink a pile of water with it, if you're trying to get back to normal, okay? Because I've had some fat people pound like 10,000 milligrams a day to catch up. As long as they're not hammering the water back, they don't have an issue with blood pressure or anything. Okay, how can you? Okay, the salt, when you dry load it, there's no fucking water to bring up the fucking blood pressure. Okay? And you're just gonna let it go. Your kidneys will regulate it. You'll just let it go. Okay? But like I said, if you don't understand this shit, don't fucking do it. Don't fucking do it. And if you're extremely fat, to simplify things, for a guy my size, okay? If I'm fucking low in fucking sodium hard, so let's say I'm good on my potassium. And let's say I was going out for a fucking some hard cardio, sweating like a pig. And let's say I'm going to take a bunch of salt. Maybe I take a fucking 2,000 milligrams every 2 hours all fucking day. All right? Well, if I taste my piss and it tastes like ocean water, I know I'm good. And at that point, I'll be thirsty as fuck. Some of you fat pigs, your piss won't taste like ocean water right away because you're fucking dumping so much fucking water from the water retention. You won't taste the ocean water piss right away. But you might feel lightheaded from losing so much water too quick. So you gotta pay attention to that. So if that happens, cut the fucking dry salt loading back for a bit and fucking catch up. Okay, it's fucking common sense. Listen to your fucking body. Now, with me, or let's say somebody's like 20 or 30 pounds, if you get really high in the salt when you're urinating ocean water, you're gonna be thirsty as fuck at that point. A lot of fat asses, they won't even be that thirsty after they pounded a ton of sodium and they're dumping water because their water volume in their body is so fucking high from retaining all the water because they were so low on sodium for so fucking long that they're not gonna be that thirsty. Yesterday when I loaded up 20,000, I started getting thirsty like midway through the day and I tasted my piss and it was like ocean water. And obviously I'm gonna get thirsty because at that point I'm fucking urinating out I'm over urinating water. I'm getting actually dehydrated because I'm fucking hammering so much sodium. So I'm dying for a drink. But my salt is high. The sodium is high. So I can drink a bunch of water. Guess what's gonna happen? My body's gonna take the water that it needs, actually needs, because water is there just to push electrolytes. It's gonna take the water it actually needs, and I'm just gonna piss out the rest. I'm not gonna be like the fucking sodium deprived idiot that's gonna just hold all that water and not piss for like, I've seen people not piss for like 5 fucking days because they're holding every ounce. Especially the fatter you are, the more capacity you have in that moment to hold water. Like somebody that's 500-600 pounds, their water holding capacity is insane. They might be holding 30, 40 pounds of water. But even me, bloated to the tits, I'm only gonna hold maybe like 6. Okay, I'd have to fucking hammer back sodium and water and blow it up to the point where my veins are blowing out of my head from high blood pressure to fucking get up to when I'm holding like 12 fucking liters of water or some shit in my body. And then I'll just piss it out the next day because my salt's still good. So I'll just piss out all the water. It'll just take time to settle down and then my body will just let go of it because my salt's good. Okay, taste your piss, motherfuckers. Taste your piss. If you're fucking chugging water all fucking day and still thirsty and you're not pissing regularly and you're not dropping water at all, you're holding water. You're in water holding mode, okay? You gotta crank sodium up and you can get very aggressive with it, okay? Most people on the internet are gonna be too chicken shit to tell you this. You can fucking crank it the fuck up, especially if you're dry loading it. And that's another thing, if you're eating strict keto, fuck, you know what cranks your metabolism through the fucking roof? Fucking salt. A ton of it. Okay? Same with fucking the long fast. See how the veins are popping out of my arms? That would never be happening on a low carb routine that I'm on right now if I wasn't cranking the sodium up. Okay, I'm hot as fuck. Metabolism's rev. A lot of people, they'll fucking jump on a fucking 20-80 keto routine and they'll be fucking flat as fuck. No pump. Or people that are on a long fast. That's why, because your sodium is fucking low as fuck. Crank up the fucking sodium. Hit the minimum on the fucking potassium. Don't fucking dry salt load snake juice packets, because there's a fuckload of potassium in them. And don't dry load fucking potassium chloride fucking powder that you might have bought at the grocery store if you're not using the packets to make fucking snake juice. Okay? So try it out. Don't fucking die. Okay? Don't die. You'll lose a fucking ton of fucking water weight if you do it properly. Take your time. Don't get all fucking excited and have a big fucking hard on or a wet pussy because you think you're gonna just dump fucking 10 pounds of water in 1 hour and get all fucked up. Ease the salt in. Get up at the start. Keep loading fucking salt until you taste seawater piss. At that point, you're okay to fucking go back to fucking just easing it in and just always be tasting your piss and go by how you fucking feel. If you're dropping weight on the scale stupid fast, like 5-6 pounds in like the day or half a day, slow it the fuck down, pull back the salt a little bit so you don't get lightheaded from dropping water weight so fucking quick. To sum everything up one last time, more fucking sodium if you're fasting on a low carb keto diet. You're chronically fucking low. Okay? You want to be in water dumping mode. How do you get there? Fucking crank up the fucking sodium, taste your piss, salty fucking piss. Do not dry load potassium fucking chloride via snake juice or the fucking powder. And fucking number 5, abs. You want abs? Always be salty, motherfucker. Always be a salty fucking bitch. Until next time, get that fucking salt in, fucking, and stop fucking eating fat.